Hello everyone, my name is Shahin. I'm working for Fossology community since last 7 years. I'm a contributor as well as maintainer to Fossology community. With me, I have my colleague Gaurav Mishra. Today's topic is hands-on training on Fossology.
Hi. Thank you for intro, Shaheen. So first we'll see what Fossology actually is. So it is a web-based application for license and copyright compliance. So it was started by HP, and in 2008, they open sourced it under GPL 2.0 license. In 2015, it became part of Linux Foundation collaboration project. So Fossology is a web-based and command line based interfaces are there for to access Fossology tool. So Fossology also has a huge bunch of agents. So agent is nothing but your scanners, which look for license and copyright relevant statements in the source code. And since Fossology is a web-based tool as well, it supports multi-user and multi-tenant interface. So with this in the web UI, you can use it to organize all your clearing jobs. On the development end, it is a standard web application stack, which includes your Apache, Postgres, and PHP. And of course, a Linux-based operating system. The web interface of Fossology is mostly written in PHP, and some of the agents are also in PHP, but all the speed critical agents are written in C and C++. Beside the web interface, Fossology also have multiple command line tools and utilities which you can use if you are running it on your machine, or it also exposes REST API, which can be used from external clients to communicate with the server.
Okay, how does Fossology work? So you upload a component to Fossology, like it might be anything like zip, tar, etc. Then you select the agents that are required for scanning. For example, Nomos for license scanning, copyright agent for copyright scanning, and ECC for export control scanning. And keyword agent to look for your keywords. So after the scanning gets finished, you review the scanner result. If there are some wrong license classifications, then you remove them and you review the scanner findings of copyrights and export control. Later, you generate the reports. So we support different reporting formats. One is SPDX reporting, generation of README file, that is a text format, and then a unified report, the Word format, and Debian copyright format. You can use this report for documentation.
So you may ask, what is special about Fossology? There are several different projects which do this license scanning for you. So Fossology boasts a very feature-rich interface for reviewing your results before putting it into something as concrete as a report. So as you know, Fossology became an open source project in 2008, and it is 2021. So Fossology has been through various iterations on its user interface. You can already see some of the changes on the web interface of it, how it evolved over the time. So currently, Fossology supports a huge packages which contains more than 10,000 files, some such as Boost library, your Linux kernel, or any Linux based operating system. You can also upload upload their disk image.
So in the hands-on part, we'll have basic end-to-end workflow using Fossology. From uploading to generating report, first we'll do uploading, then reviewing of uploaded file in license browser, and then reviewing of the uploaded file in the aggregated view. Then we'll do some clearing, and then we'll review the copyrights. Then we'll review the export control and keywords. Then we generate the desired report for output. So today we are using Apache Thrift as an example to do the clearing. So on the right hand side of the slide, you see different options with which we are going to do the clearing. Okay, Fossology 390 release. 390 was released in last December. So this release adds important features and bug fixes. We have listed down features which are important for this release. So in that, first one is introduce support for Ubuntu Focal Fossil. Then drop support for Debian 8 SE. Then extend support for Postgres 12. Then obligations now refer to license conclusions. Then we have auto deactivation of copyrights for event files. So whenever there is a decision of irrelevant, then the copyrights related to that file will get deactivated automatically. Then we have provided ability to specify grid branch in an upload from version control systems. Then REST API, which now supports upload from URL. So display time setting has been changed according to your time zone. Then we have added an ability to export copyright statements as CSV. Then we have removed open SSL dependency and used libg script instead of that. So 390 release also introduces new agent, which is PUST, which connects with clearly defined server and pulls important information like licenses and copyrights. We are also planning for Fossology 310 release. So as part of that, we have released release candidate. First release candidate. So here we have dropped the support for PHP 5 and updated dependencies for PHP 7. We have updated the password hashing algorithm from SHA-1 to more secure bcrypt. Then we have added an ability to search a file using hash in REST API. We have also added new licenses from SPDX 3.10, and we have done many fixes as part of like license identification through Nomos. We have introduced the feature for advanced search and replace in copyrights. We have developed a feature to enforce password policies. So now you can enable this feature from admin tab. We have also added a feature to import acknowledgements from Gnosis file. And then we have changed the versioning scheme to include the patch number from Git. And then Unpack agent can be compiled to work in a standalone mode. So these are the important fixes or features that were done in RC1 3.10.
Hi, so there are various ways to install Fossology, but today we'll look into Docker, which is the most easiest and the simplest way to get it started with Fossology. So you can scroll down to the README and come to the Docker section. So all our images are already pre-built and available on Docker Hub. You can go to tags and see various tags. So the latest tag for the Docker image is always in sync with the master branch on a repo. But if you need something more concrete, we also tag all of our major releases which are available here. So for today's demo, I'll pull the latest image from Docker. I'll just copy, paste. And since I have already pulled the image recently on my machine, it should not take much long. But if you are doing it for the very first time, it's just 200 MB in size. So as you can see, the image is up to date. So now we can proceed to the next step, which is to run the Docker image. I'll copy the command from GitHub, paste it here, and make a few changes. I'll give the name Fossology to my Docker container just to make it easy for me to manage it, and I'll run it in detached mode. So after doing this, my machine's port 8081 will be mapped to the container's port 80. And let's open the logs for our container and see what is going on here. So as you can see, Fossology is currently initializing itself in the database. And very soon you will see a message from the scheduler, which is the background daemon, which manages everything, and a few logs from Apache. So our server is ready on Docker. Now we can head over to localhost port 8081/repo, and we should be greeted by the welcome page of Fossology. So the default username would be Fossy, and the default password will be Fossy to log in. And no, I don't want to save this. And yeah, your Fossology server is ready. However, we would still recommend you to use the Docker Compose, which is over here. Why? Because as you already know, the Docker's file system is not persistent. So with the Docker Compose, we have taken care of the persistence with the help of volume. And also your database will run as a separate container, which on its own has additional performance advantages. But yes, for today's demo, a single Docker container should be good enough.
Okay, once your instance is up, you need to download the packages to run in Fossology. So as Apache Thrift package is high in size, we have shifted to Twig packages. So to download the Twig package, you need to go to GitHub. So here you will search for Git Twig. You see here different Twig packages are listed here. So we'll pick up the first one, Twig PHP. From here, we'll go to tags. I'll just scroll down. Okay, we'll see a bit older package. Let's say we download version 1.43.0. So you need to click on tar so that your package will get downloaded. And then once this package has been downloaded, you will need to download one more package. Why you have to download another package, I will tell you. But first, you guys need to download it. So go to previous. Then, okay, let's download 1.44.2 by clicking tar. So once this package also gets downloaded, let's go back to Fossology instance. So I'll go and log in to Fossology instance using the default username and password, which is Fossy, and password will be Fossy. I don't want to save the password, so I'll say don't save. So once we log in, we'll be landed up in the browse view. So we see here there is no package which got uploaded. So to upload the package to Fossology, we go to upload from file, because we have already downloaded the package. So we click on the file. Here we have different options. Let's say we need to select the folder name. If you have different folders, then to which folder you want to upload this package, you can select that folder and you can upload there. So for now, I don't have any folders. So I'll upload to the default root folder, which is software repository. So then I'll click browse. Then I'll go to T drive, where I think I have downloaded the packages here. In the D drive, I'll select the sample uploads. So here I have different packages. So first we'll upload the Twig 1.43.0 tar. I'll click open. Then if we want some description for this package, we can enter here, which is optional, obviously. So there is a fourth option which ignores SEM files, Git, FAS, particular MIME type. So if you want to ignore them, you can tick this fourth option. But for now, I am just going on and clicking copyright, export control, keyword analysis, MIME type. Which is not required, but I'll not check. So I'll go for Monk, Nomos, and then Ojo. So package analysis and software heritage analysis are not required now. And I'll just click upload. So we'll see the package has been uploaded as a message. And if I click the upload, so upload already started processing. So I'll come back to upload from file view. Where we'll see different options. We have stopped here in the fourth option. So in the fifth option, we have a visible to active group, whichever the active group is there, visible to that group. So active group means the group which is there listed here. So visible to all groups, whichever may be the group, the upload will be visible to all the groups. So make it public. So the upload will be public. So in the sixth, we have option analysis where we have a copyright email URL author. So internally, this will have an agent which will process your each file and search for copyrights, emails, URLs, and authors. So we'll have export export analysis, which scans for export restrictions. And we have keyword analysis, which scans for particular keywords, whichever we have. So in the keyword analysis, we'll have a conf file where you can configure your specified keywords and you can scan for those keywords. So mime type, I'm ignoring now, which is not required. So monk analysis is a text-based analysis. So it will scan for licensed text. And then we have Nomos, which scans for licenses using regular expressions and keywords. And then we have Ojo license analysis, which scans for specific SPDX license IDs using SPDX license identifier text. So we also have package analysis and software heritage analysis, which are not required. Then we have seventh option, which is automatic conclusions. So we'll come back to this part later. Now we'll go to jobs view where we have uploaded the quick package. So we'll see how it is getting processed. So if you come now, you can see that the package what we have uploaded has already been processed. So first it has run the unpack agent where it will unpack all the files recursively, and then ADJ to nest agent, which will store your files, whatever the unpacked files are there in the database, using nested analysis. And then we have scheduled the copyright, export control, and keyword agents, as well as the Monk and Nomos and Ojo. So about these agents, I have already explained you in the upload from file page. So now we'll go to the browse view. So in the browse view, you can see that your package arrived here. So we have the package name and description here. So if I have not added any description, but if I have added it, then it will come next to this. So then we have the status bar where it says that open, in progress, closed, or rejected. So the clearing person can mark this status so that he will know in future what is the progress, or if he has closed this package, or he has rejected it. Then we have the comment bar, which will indicate the comments of this package. So this comment bar will get enabled once you reject this package or close this package. Then we have this main license bar, where all the main licenses you select will get appear. And then we have assigned to. So assigned to will have different usernames. So as this package is assigned to you, you may not need to assign this. So if you have different users, you want to assign a package to some user, then you can select his name. And then we have upload date and priority. Priority is used to set the priorities for your uploads, so that if you have multiple uploads, which packets to scan early or which packets needs to be ignored or scanned later, you can set it here. So if I come to the first thing, I have a select action here. So in the select action, I have different options. So first option is file browser, where you can just see the files which are there in this package. So I have view, where you can view this source code. And I have con, which will go to the configuration page, where we'll come back to it later. And then we have info. So info page, it will go to info page, and the package information will get listed here. Then you have compare option, where you can compare this package with different packages. So if we have different Twig packages, there you can compare which files have been changed and different things. And then we have corporate email URL analysis, then download. Then we have different reporting formats. So you can export DevFi, README OSS, SPX, RDF, tag value, and unified report. But these things are not required now. Once we do the clearing, we'll come back to this part. Then we have report import, licenses, tag, and history. So history will show the package history. And now we'll click on licenses to go to the clearing view. So once we are in the clearing view, we have landed up in a file. So if you see here, the content is already a dummy. So there is no license here. So we'll go to the next file by clicking next button. So next file is also an empty. Yeah, next file is also a file which has empty licenses. So if you see here, there is no such text which indicates a license. So instead of going next, I will select an option which go through all the files with licenses. Because I may not go to each and every file which don't have license and check it. So I'll click on the option, go through all the files with licenses, and then I'll go to next. So I have arrived in a page which don't have licenses, but it says that there is a CDoc license. So I'll just scroll down so that to check if there is some license here, or license header, or license text, or copyright, or something. So I think it will be hectic for me to look into each and everything. So I'll see why Nomos has found out this CDoc other license. So to check that, I'll click on this. In the source, hash one. So that it will highlight the text from which it has detected the CDoc license. So see the documentation for syntax used before. So I see that this is a not relevant license. So I'll mark this file as irrelevant and then I'll go to the next file. So here I see that there is a BSD style license. I'll click on source and hash one to find the actual text. So here it says redistribution and use in source and binary forms with or without modifications are permitted provided by the condition. So applying the license for file met BSD 3 clause. So I'll if I want, I can check the license, actual license text here. I see that there is a small text which is there for BSD style. So I close it, it will not reference me. In this case, you can go and check for BSD style license in Google and check the license text. But for now, what I do is I copy this license text from here to here, from copyright to the email. I'll copy this text, I'll paste it in license text, because I don't have the license text, as well as this text may be different from the actual BSD 3 clause license text, so that for documentation it will be required for me. So I'll paste it here and then I'll say okay. So the license text will get added here. If there are some acknowledgements or comments, then I'll add acknowledgements here next to the license text, and then I'll add the comments here next to the acknowledgements. So now I have different options here for clearing type: no license known, to be discussed, do not use, irrelevant, and identified. So if the files are irrelevant, I'll mark them as irrelevant. If you see the last file, we have marked that file as irrelevant because it didn't have the relevant license text. Now I'll see there is a potential of license text here. So I say identify, and then I'll submit the result. So this result got submitted. And stored in the database. So later, if you come up, you will see a decision scope. So it says apply decision to all future occurrences of this file. So if you are uploading a package with the same file in the future, then this option will help you to mark them as identified or whatever your decision type may be in the future. So if you click this and submit the result, then in the later versions of Twig, if this file occurs without any modification, then this decision will get added. If you come downside, we have different buttons. One is user decision, one is bulk recognition, and one is clearing history. Obviously, with the name, clearing history means the history of the clearing decision, so which will get appeared here. So you see date, user, and then decision scope. So First, I have marked this file as identified, so which is a local decision with BSD3 BSD style license. And then I have made this file global decision. So it says the scope is global. So we'll come back to bulk recognition later in this video. Now we'll see what is user decision. If suppose there is another license here, suppose there is a text of 389 exception, or you say some ad hoc 2006 license which appears here, then you need to add that license to your decision. So at this point you use user decisions to add the decisions. Why we call it user decision is whatever the finding is here, this is by agent. So whatever the finding we do here, that is by user, who are us. So we'll add the user decision from this tab. So you can always search for some different licenses here. So suppose if I search for MIT, so MIT will get up here and different variants of MIT which are there in Fossology. So whichever the license is required, we can add it. So I'm closing the user decision tab, and then I'll move on to the next file. So in the next file, I see the file header is same as the previous file. So I'll go and check the tree view here by clicking the folder, by clicking the package name below the folder. I'll go here. I'll see that there are only two scanner findings for this file. So so the bulk is not required. So I'll come back here. I'll say identify. I'll apply this decision for future occurrences. I'll copy the information, text information, whatever is there here. I'll add it in the license text. And then I'll say OK. So once you add the license text, you have to submit the decision again. Because if there were some changes, then it will be a change in the history. So the type will become WIP, so work in progress. So with that, you have to submit your decision again. So your decision will automatically get submitted once you click next. So it says that there is a BSD 3 clause license in this file. So let me check the license text with which it has found out. So there is some text which is says that, okay, this is an URL, this is not a license. So this license finding is irrelevant. But if I come up, I have seen that there is something in this file. which states that for full copyright and license information, please view the license file that was distributed with this source code. Okay, it says that you have to view the license file for copyright and license information. So without removing this license, I'll just go to the tree view. So to go to the tree view, you know that you have to click on Twig below the folder. I'll go here. I will click on the Twig package. Then I'll come inside the package where I see different folders and files inside that Twig package. And I see the license information. And I also see which scanner has been found the licenses. If you see this file, Nomos found, no license found. But if you see the license file, Nomos has found BSD 3 clause as well as Monk. So Monk shows the percentage of text map. So Monk has found the similar text almost. Which is 94%. After that, you see the edited results below this. Whatever the results you edit will get displayed. And then the clearing status. So if all the files in this folder are clear, then this status will get to green color. The gray color ones are the ones where Fossology has found no license. If you want, you can check this file. So all the files should have no license found. So to check that, you have to click on this package. Not the package, the folder. So LibTwig. So I see here each and every folder as well as file have the no license found. If you want, you can go to each file and check if there is a license text or not. But for now, I have confidence in Nomos, so I'm just keeping this thing. I'll go back to one level up by clicking on this Twig 1430. So I have one level up where I see the folder what we have just viewed. And then we have the clearing status red, where agent has found something, but we have not edited the results or decided the files. At this case, it will be red. And then next to the clearing status, we have the count. So it says clear versus open versus total. So you see, I have cleared one file in the doc folder, and there are open files which are one file was open, so I have cleared that, and there are total 94 files. So if we see the decision inside this doc file, we have just made it irrelevant. So for cdoc license, we have made that file irrelevant. So documentation folder, we mark it as irrelevant. So if the files are many, then you can do it as a bulk option where you have to edit the clearing decision from here, and you mark them as irrelevant or do not use as required. So for now, I use this option mark as irrelevant. But before clicking mark as irrelevant, you see that from here you can also add the licenses to the files. So if there is a case where you need to add the same license to whole folder, then you can use this option to add or remove the licenses. So now I'll go back to mark decision as irrelevant. I'll click on it. So Fossology will automatically submit and add the irrelevant decision to the files which are only open, not to the files which are not open. You can say it will not add the decisions to the total files, but it will add the decision to the file which for which agent has found something. So now after this we'll check the license file. So we see here there is a BSD3 clause license. So I'll check the monk. And Nomos. So both Nomos and Monk have found the BSD 3 clause license, and I see that this license text is almost the same with the license text here. So yes, I will mark this file as identified, and then I'll make this as the main license for this source code. I have to do it by clicking on the star inside the action. So once you click it, the star will glow into yellow color. So I see that there is no change in the license text. I'll just submit this. And copy this license text. For the files which says C license file. So I'll add the text here, the license text of BSD3 clause. I'll say OK. Then I'll identify this file as BSD3 clause and submit the decision. So So if you see here, we have one more option which says go through all the files with licenses and no crealing result. So it will go through all the files with licenses and no clearing result where we have not decided the files. I'll use this option. I'll go to the next file which has the licenses but no clearing result. So we have the same test which states that for the full copyright and license information, please view the license. So it will be hectic for me if I see this type of files in every part of the source code, and I have to edit the results manually. So what I'll do is now I'll go to the bulk recognition mode. Here I'll remove the license unclassified. I'll add the license BSD 3 clause. And in the license text bar, I'll copy the license text from the license file, which I have already copied in the last for the last clearing. So I'll just add this license text here. I have added the license text, and then to recognize this type of file, you need to add the reference text. So I'm adding reference text as this. So I've taken for full copyright and license information, please view the license file. So I'll clean the text and then I'll schedule a bulk scan. So once the bulk scan is scheduled, you see the job number here. You click on this job. Okay, before clicking, I think the bulk has processed our request and it has done the needful for us. It has added the copyright as well as BSD 3 clauses bulk. So we'll go to show jobs page to see the agent which has run. So once you schedule the monk well, once you schedule the bulk recognition, it will run the monk well, then the decider job. So monk well is to find the license text, you say reference text, whatever we have pasted, and then decider job is to decide the file. So I'll come back here to browse, then to licenses. I see that the clearing data has been changed. So there are several files which have the text, and using bulk recognition, we have marked them as identified with the license text. So now we'll go through files with licenses and no clearing result. So here, if you see, Bulk has added the result, but it has not identified it, but the action is work in progress. This is because, if you remember, we have added unclassified license. With the Bulk, we have removed the unclassified license and added the BSD3 clause. So if you come to this file, Nomos has not identified unclassified license, but it has identified CURL. So which is not relevant. So I am going to remove this license here. And then I'll say identify, and I'll manually submit the decision. If you see here, we have to do the same action for this file as well. I'll make it identified. I'll remove the CURL and then I'll go to the next file. So you see there is a PHP possibility license. So her Nomos said that there might be a possibility of PHP license. So I'll click on hash. So I don't think there is some relevant text which says there is a PHP license here. So I'll just remove this license. I'll add the decision type. Then I'll submit the results. So if you come to this file, there is a README file. So it says that quick template for PHP released under new BSD license, which is not a license text. So I say irrelevant and submit the result. There is a composer file, so which says there is a license BSD3 clause. This file is irrelevant anyway, so I'll mark this as irrelevant and I'll submit the result. With this, we have cleared almost all the files and the Twig package. So now we'll go to the folder view to see how it looks. So you see that the clearing status is green. So it states that we have cleared all the files inside Twig 1430. So you see here. So everything is green. Now we download the report for documentation. To do that, I'll go to browse. I'll select the action. I I click on Export Unified Report, which is the Word document report. So a job gets scheduled, and yeah, we have generated our report successfully. I have opened the file, the Word file, which got generated by Fossology. So I see different options here, clearing information, component information, it has some department prepared by community, etc., etc. These things we'll discuss later in this video, but for now, I'll check the licenses, what I have cleaned. So if there were some acknowledgements, that acknowledgements will get added here. So in this video, we have not added any acknowledgement because we didn't find any acknowledgement. So we'll come down. So we see the results of scan, like scanner count, what, how many licenses we have concluded, and name of the license. So for the main license, we have added BSD 3 clause license as a main license. So this will display the main license, text, and the file name. So you see the difference, you see that there are two BSD 3 clause licenses, but the file names are not segregated. This is because you see that we have added the actual finding here. But if you see this, we have added the found license text inside the quick file. So that is the difference between these two. So apart from that, there is no difference. That is why they are listed separately. I see the different license files which have the BSD 3 clause license. And then if I see the other licenses, we have the BSD style license. And we have the copyrights. I think the copyrights were not cleaned. So we'll clean the copyrights in this video later. So I'm closing the report. I'm back here. On the browser. Now, we'll see the copyright clearing.
Yeah, so thank you, Shane, for clearing all the licenses. So to do the license copyright clearing, either from under the actions, you can go to copyright. This will take you individual files which have a copyright, or so the copyright agent also recognizes URLs and emails. Or the other way to do that is you can open the package, and in the top yellow bar you see there are various different sections. So you will see copyright over here. So if I click on it, it will give me a nice table which contains all the copyrights inside this particular upload. So you see there are various copyrights listed over here, and I can either check on them. So let's say we want to check from where this copyright came from. So to do that, I just need to click on the count, which is one over here. And this tells me this is coming from this file called core-extension.php. I just need to open it, and this is one of the copyright. And if I scroll down, I should see the other one, but it is not here. If I scroll even further, so it is somewhere here. So this actually comes from, looks like this comes from another code which is taken from Zend framework and imported into the Twig. So it depends on your company policy, how you can handle this. So you can either ignore this copyright, or you can preserve it. So for this hands-on video, I will ignore this because this is not something generated by the Twig. So on the right, if you see, you will find a heading called Scanner Findings. So under that, you will find there are two copyrights in this particular file. So I can click on the red button right next to the copyright I want to deactivate. So as soon as I do this, I should see a deactivated action over here. There is also an option to undo this because you might have done it by mistake, or later you change your mind and you decided like this copyright is relevant for this clearing. So you can always undo. But if now I reload the page, the copyright itself is gone from the activated statements. So what if I want to reactivate it now? So I just need to scroll down, and the copyright should be there under the deactivated statements. So I can undo it from here if required, and it should pop back to the activated statements. So now let's go back to our folder view, and we see there are two deactivated copyrights with us, and there are many activated copyrights. So let's check on one more example. Let's say this copyright by Twig, which comes from the license file. So yeah, this seems like a nice clean copyright, which is also valid. So I am not going to touch anything here. So we'll go back to our folder view. And from here, you can also change the formatting of the copyright. There are some ways to edit it. So for example, I don't want a period at the end of this copyright. So I just need to click on it, do the modification, and let's say I don't want this term by the, I just need copyright 2009 to 2020 by 15, and I just hit enter. So my copyright is modified, looks much cleaner now. Same thing I'll do for this copyright. I'll remove this bar from the end and I'll hit enter. And for all the other copyrights, you can leave them as is, or I will add the text copyright in front of them. So for that, let's try to use the advanced search feature. To do that, you first need to select the copyrights you want to be modified in the right-hand corner. And you can also search, if this table is too big, you also have a search bar at the top. You can use it. But since there are only 5 rows and I need the top three, I'll just select them. And in the advanced search section, you need to type in kind of a regex you want to search. So the text I want to search starts with copyright. And this parenthesis and an asterisk means anything, just like a dot a star in your regex. So this will match all of the 3 selected copyrights for me. So I can create a replacement text by clicking on this button. So anything which is there matched by this parenthesis and an asterisk will be recreated over here with a $1, as it's generally done by regex. And what I need to do is to add a copyright in front of the C. So I will write my additional text, copy right and a space. So before submitting it, I can do a test over here. So it will take the first entry from all the selected entries, and it show how it will transform in the form part to the final part. And I can click on replace selected rows. So it will do the same operation on all the selected rows. So it looks much more consistent now. You also have the same deactivation buttons with the red color over here, and the same deactivated statements on the bottom. You can activate them at any time you need. And you see over here, there is also a tab called User Findings, which is currently empty. So if I come back to License Browser view and open one of the file, for example, let's say not changelog, something like a Travis file. So Fossology gives you an ability to add copyright text which Fossology could not find, or you want some other things to be added. So I have opened Travis file, which is currently in the license view. I will change it to the copyright view. And let's say I'll add a text finding. Under text finding, I'll write copyright by the Twig team, since there was no copyright added to this particular file. I can also add a description for this particular copyright, saying giving the credits to the team. And there is also an optional field comment. You can also add some comment. Since copyrights were missing from this file, added one manually. So other than the text finding box, the description and the comment are optional. So similar to license clearing, you have the same button called identified for the copyrights as well, and you just hit submit. So your copyright will be added under the current decisions. And now if we go back to the folder view, under my user findings tab, I will have that copyright popping up over here with the same ability to disable it. So that is it with the copyright. You also have the export control scanning as well, which is under the ECC tab on the same yellow bar. So you see this this statement does not look like valid. Anyways, let's investigate it more. So similar to copyright, you just need to click on the number. It shows it's coming from the environment.php file. And if I open it up and I scroll down over here, so it says the last line of defense if either some caching was used. So this does not look to me like a statement which prevents me from exporting this code. So I can mark it as irrelevant from here itself. And I can come to SRC, or I can either remove it from here, from the folder view. So let's do it from here. And this ECC finding has also been marked as deactivated. Then the third tab is called as email URL author. This is captured by the copyright agent. And I will just go one level up in the folder view. So I see all the emails from the whole package. So if you see, it has captured many emails, which almost all of them look valid. If not, you can anyways deactivate it like the copyrights. You can edit them. You can use the same advanced search and replace feature here. Then we'll go to the URL. They all look okay, except this domain.invalid, which does not look like a valid domain. So instead of removing it one by one, I'll just check this tick box and I'll deactivate all of them at once. Then if I scroll even further, I don't see any more invalid URLs on this particular table. So with just one, I can scroll down and click on the deactivate selected rows button. So this particular URL has been marked as deactivated. So you can also do the same clearing, like there is a parenthesis at the end of this URL. I can remove it, hit enter. I can go to the next page and do all sort of stuff. Then you also have author table, which shows you the name of the author, which are picked up from the source code. So for example, this particular row seems not to be okay to me. This is okay. This is nice. I'll deactivate this and the last three rows. So I'll select them again using the same deactivate selected rows. I'll deactivate all those authors, and I can also refresh my page. So my table rebuilds and I have all the deactivated authors on the bottom. Again, I can do the same sort of stuff over here if required. So let's try to remove the author text from the beginning of all the entries using the advanced search and replace function. So I'll select all the entries. I will search for the text author, followed by a space, followed by anything. And I'll hit on the create replacement text, and I'll remove the author section from my regex. I'll do a test replacement, seems fine, and I'll hit the replace selected rows, and the page reloads. The author text is gone from the beginning of all these entries. And at the last, you have a keyword scanning as well. So for this particular package, no keywords were found, but they all work as in the same way as the copyright. You can always go to individual file, and you again have the same option to add manual keywords, or if I go to ECC, I can manually add ECC if I found anything in this particular file. So let's go back to our browse view and try to generate the report again. So on the same package, I'll go down and export the unified report. So it is being generated and it's done. So I'll open the file, wait for it to be rendered by LibreOffice. And now if I scroll down after the license section in the copyrights, this looks much more clean now. This is my first copyright. And if I scroll even further, there are more of them. So you see the format of this table. On the left, you have copyright statement, and any comments, if they were added, will be in the middle section. And all the file paths where this particular copyright was found will be on the third row. Third column. And if I scroll down, you can see under the user findings, this is the copyright we added to our Travis file and with the comment. So with this, the report looks much more nice. Let's try to generate one more report. Again, I'll come back to my browse view. In the same select action, let's try to generate the Debian copyright report, Deb5. And open it with a text editor. So you already have it in a proper Deb5 format, which lists the files, the particular copyright, the particular license, for all the files in the package. And you also have some generation documentation, what is the format, what is the name, you can modify it, some contact details, source, disclaimer, and also the comment when this file was generated with Fossology. So this file, this particular upload, I'm done with this. I have done the clearing. Shane has done the clearing. The main license was added and the copyright was also filtered and cleaned. So now I can change the status for this particular upload and mark it as closed. So it gives me a pop-up which asks me to enter a particular reason to change this status of the upload. So I can write here, clearing is done. Copyrights are also cleaned. And I'll hit OK. So the status of my upload is changed to close, and now there is a comment under the comment section. So the clearing for this package is done. Now let's see some advanced feature with Fossology which are related to license handling. So if you go to the admin section, you see under license admin, you have an option called select license. If you just click on it, you will come to the license administration page. And if you click find, so it will list all the licenses which are there in the Fossology server. You see at the moment I have 603 licenses. This will change over time. As you scan new package, Nomos will add some more licenses. or you can also add them under the same admin section. Go to license admin and you have a add license page. But we'll not do it today. We'll see the last column over here, which is called as an obligation. So what is the use of it? So as we just cleaned our package with BSD3 clause license, if I click on the edit on the leftmost of the row, this is all the license relevant information associated with the BSD3 clause license. You see at the bottom there is an option called as associated obligations, so which are all the obligations you need to follow with a particular BSD3 clause license. So let's create an obligation, so which again is an administrative task, so you will find it under admin, obligation admin, and add obligation. So on my second tab, I'll just open this particular license and I'll create an obligation for this particular clause in the license, which states neither the name of the contributors can be used for endorsement of the products. Or I can, so this is specific to Twig. Let's make a general one. So I'll again go to the admin, license admin, and select license. I'll hit find. Under the sort name, I'll search for BSD3 clause. I'll edit it. And I'll copy this third section. I'll come back to my first tab where I'm creating a new obligation. In the name of the obligation topic, I'll mark it, I can name it as no endorsement. So you can also add different type of obligations. It can be a simple obligation or a restriction, a risk, or a particular right. So I'll leave it to obligation. And for the obligation text, I'll paste the section I copied from the license. So this will end up in your report. So there is also an optional level of the obligation attention. I will mark it under yellow. So your organization can have multiple levels, green, white, yellow, or red. Then does this obligation apply on modified source code? I will say yes. And associated license. So which license I want to associate with this particular obligation? So I want to associate my BSD3 clause license. I'll select it over here. You can also add multiple licenses. Let's add one more BSD3. Let's say BSD3 clause attribution license. So similarly, you can add multiple licenses over here. There is also a concept called candidate license, which we will not cover. And some optional comment you can also add, but I will not touch it. And then there is a section to mark the text as updatable. So I will click it no, and I'll show you the reason. And then I'll click on the button, add obligation. So it says obligation, no endorsement associated with these two particular licenses was added. So on the same page, from topic, I'll make all topic find. So this shows my obligation. Now if I click on edit again, this particular text is a read only. So if you remember, we just marked the text updatable as no. So this prevents accidental modifications. If someone needs to modify this particular obligation text, they have to come here, mark text updatable to yes, update the obligation, edit it again, change it. So it requires some additional effort to prevent accidental modifications. So now let's go back to our browse view and generate one final report. So one final, not a final, but another export, unified report. We'll export it just to see how our obligations will end up in the report. So the report is here. Is here under section 2, 2.2. So my obligation is here, the same name, no endorsement, and the obligation text is over here. So yeah, there are more modifications you can do with the report, for which I'll call Shaheem back.
Okay, thank you, Gaurav. Now we'll see how to edit the conf page where we configure the unified report obligations for a particular package, not for the whole Fosology, for a particular package. So we'll go here. We'll select the conf page. So once you select the conf page, you see different tabs. One is Unified Report Settings. Another one is Obligations in Unified Report. This one is SPDF Report Settings. And then we have another tab called Decision Settings. Okay. So first we'll discuss about Unified Report Tests. Settings. So in the unified report settings, on the right hand side, you will see different headings of unified report. So unified report is the word report. So you see the headings, and this heading and the content below this heading is enabled. So if you don't want the content of assessment summary, acknowledgements, or export restrictions or anything in this heading listing, then you can just uncheck it and submit the result here, so that the unchecked one will not get appeared in your unified report. So on the left hand side, you see different inputs. So copyright text. So here it says your organization. So let's say you work for some X company. So I say X copyright. Copyright. See some X organization. So you can add the copyright here. So we have a heading called reviewed by. So this will be edited by the reviewed person. So once you do the clearing, an expert or someone who's who take case of this will review this, and they'll say they'll add their name here, and then department. And so for now it is Fosology Generation. If you are under some department, then you can add your department there. So I say for department, I'll add Fosology Generation hands-on And then we have a report release date, then from which community we have copied it. So we have the component information, version of the package. I'm not going to edit everything, but I'll add just few things. I'll say 1.43.0. Sorry, my log is off. 1.43.0. Okay, and then I have the release date and the mainline or software SW360 portal link. And then I can add general assessment. So I can check some options for binary integration nodes. So if there are some critical files found in the source code or not, then I can add the dependency nodes, additional rules. If there are risks, then I can add those risks. So everything will get displayed in a unified report. So for now, I say there are no risks. So I say no restrictions found. I say no export restrictions found. And I say I have found some bindings. So if I click on this, I'll get a text area where I can fill where I have found the binary. I say I have found the somewhere in the then I say no critical information form. So I'll save the information whatever I've edited here. I'll submit it. So information whatever I have added has been saved. I'll move to the next tab, which is the obligations in unified report. If suppose there are multiple obligations, in that case, what will happen is most of the obligations which are not required to list it in the unified report will get added to your license text. So here in this case, Gaurav has added only one obligation topic, but if there are some different users, then they will also add some different obligation topics to the same licenses, with which whatever is not required for your unified report or documentation will get listed here. For that, you can exclude them by just checking the license, which obligation next to the license which are not required, and you can submit them. And then we have a setting which shows SPDX license comments. So if you want to include SPDX license comment or ignore the files with no SPDX info, then you can check this option. Just a configuration setting for SPDX reports. And then we have decision setting tab, where if you want all your clearing decisions to get global, the scope global, scope to global, then you check this information and submit it, so that an agent will get scheduled and it will convert all your local clearing to global clearings. So for now, we have changed the unified report setting. So we will generate the report and see if everything we have configured is there in the unified report. I'll download the unified report again. So I see the department name as Fossology Generation on Hands-On. So I see the configured information that no critical files have been found, and other information like version and the comment that I have entered here in the binaries. And yeah, there is one more thing, which is there are no risks which we have entered from the conf page. So that is it on the side of conf page. So now let's suppose we have gotten another component to clear, which is the next version of the quiz. So when we started this training, I have told you to download 1442. So we will upload that and see how to reuse the existing decisions of this upload. So for that, what we do is upload the later version, upload from file. I'll go to browse. I will select the next version of the twig and then I say open it. So now I'll select the scanning part. So I say I need to scan the copyrights, export control, keywords. Mime type is not required. Monk. Nomos and Pojo. So now I'll come to the automatic conclusion part. So which says the scanner matches if all Nomos findings are within the Monk findings. So if the Nomos findings are within the Monk findings, then automatically decide that file without telling me. So Fossology will automatically decide your file if the scanner matches or within the Monk findings, no scanner matches. And then I have another option which says that if Ojo findings and have no contradiction with other findings. So if the Ojo agent have found something which has no contradiction with Nomos or Monk. So in that case, you just identify the file. So I'll click this option as well. And then I have an option called bulk phrases from reused packages. So I'm gonna select a reused package. So I will copy the bulk phrases from the reused packages. So for that, I'll click on this option. So it says new scanner results, that is decisions were marked as work in progress if the scanner finds the additional licenses. So if the scanner previously found some license X and now it has found the license X and Y in the same file, then this will be a work in progress. So I'm not going to select that option here. Now I'll go to software repository folder. Okay, I have only one folder, so I don't need to select anything. So I'll come here, select an upload to reuse. I'll select the twig package, which is the lower version, 1.4.3. And then I want to reuse all the deactivated copyrights. So to do that, I need to check this option. I want to reuse the report configuration settings as well because the package is same. So I reuse this configuration settings and then I reuse the main licenses. So whatever the main licenses are there in 1.4.0, that will get reused. So I'll come down, then I'll upload the package. So the package got uploaded successfully. So I'll click on the job. Upload has three. So has three is the upload ID. So I see that there are two additional agents which are reuser and decider. So because I have reused with a bulk option, now the bulk which I have scheduled in the previous package or previous upload has been scheduled again. Job view will automatically get restarted in 10 seconds, but I'll see. I'm curious what's happening here. So I'm just refreshing it. Yeah, I see that I have scanned the 1.442 tweak very fast, and I see that there are some decisions as well as there are some additional findings which Nomos has found. So one part about Nomos is Nomos and other agencies, the files will not get scanned if they got scanned already. So yeah, okay, sorry. Then I'll go to licenses, but before that we'll see we have reused the main license, so main license got added here. So I'll go to the license tab to see how many files that got cleared. So there are almost 200 files cleared with the reuse out of 212, so which has made our job very easy. So we don't need to look into this 200 files again and again to identify it. So now I'll go to the files with licenses and no clearing result and see what are the contradictions and why these files are not clear. So I see that there is some extra file which got added in the documentation, and I see there is no license relevant statement. So I remove this license. I mark this as irrelevant and submit. Okay, we have the same problem like we found it in the last upload. So we remove the PHP possibility which is not there here, and we identify it and then we submit it next. So yeah, we make this irrelevant because it's a composer file which doesn't have the license. For this type of files, we I recommend almost you to almost just put the apply this decision to the global scope, so that if the readme files or documentation files or the files, the composer files, if they are not changed, I don't think we need to look into it, so we can directly mark them. So now we have cleared all the files in this package, so we'll go back to the browse view. And we'll close the clearing and say cleared using reuse. Tweak 1.43.0. I say okay. Then we generate the unified report for the scene. Okay. Very fast. Sorry. Now, uh, now we see that the obligations and report settings as well as the licenses in the unified report.
So we have seen in this hands-on demo end-to-end workflow you do in Fossology. We started by uploading a tweak package. We see how the license browse view and aggregated view works. We see how to do clearing, use global decisions, also the bulk findings. Then we also did the cleaning on copyrights, export controls, and the keywords. We also see different kind of reports Fossology can generate. We did not touch the SPDF report, which itself is a topic on its own, but Fossology also supports SPDF generation. Then we see how you can reuse the decisions from a previous version package to a newer version. So with the takeaways, from this demo, first of all, Fossology is an open source project, so there is no vendor lock-in. You can customize it as per your need. You can make modifications or even share it with others. And since it is a server-based web application, it allows you to do a multi-user or a multi-tenant operations. And also, with the help of the reuse feature, you can do a reuse from a previous version to a newer version, which reduces much of effort. And then you have also seen the beauty of the review process, which Fossology gives to you, which also makes your work very, very efficient with various features like reuse and bulk scan.
So you may like the project. So if you would like it and you would like to contribute to the project, then you can check our GitHub repository and also star us. So you see on the right hand side, we have different company names and logos who are using Fossology now. And then if you consider supporting us, you can send your logo to Fossology Steering at fossology.org. So your company's logo will get listed down here. Then thank you for your attention. There are different links which would help you. Thank you very much.
Yeah, thank you all for your attention. Have a good day.
Have a good day. Bye.